بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم رب يسر ولا تعسر وتمم بالخير وبك نستعين يا فتاح أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إنا كفيناك المستهزئين الذين يجعلون مع الله إلها آخر فسوف يعلمون ولقد نعلم أنك يضيق صدرك بما يقولون فسبح بحمد ربك وكن من الساجدين واعبد ربك حتى يأتيك اليقين وقال عليه الصلاة والسلام إن وقال الله تبارك وتعالى في مقام آخر إنا أعطيناك الكوثر فصل لربك وانحر إن شانئك هو الأبتر صدق الله العظيم وصدق رسوله النبي الكريم ونحن على ذلك من الشاهدين والشاكرين والحمد لله رب العالمين أما بعد All praises and gratitude are due to Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the creator, nourisher and cherisher of this universe. Peace, blessings and salutations be upon our beloved and august master and leader, Rasulullah, Khatamun Nabiyyin wal Mursaleen, Muhammad ibn Abdullah, Al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala ali Sayyidina Muhammad. كلما ذكره الذاكرون الأبرار وكلما غفل عن ذكره الغافلون. Respected brothers and sisters in Islam, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. A few months now we discussed the story of a Sahabi by the name of Sa'id ibn Amir al-Jumahi radiallahu anhu. When he witnessed the assassination or the execution of Khubayb ibn Adi radiallahu anhu. At the time he said he was still a non-Muslim, a non-believer, and he was underage. But he was amongst the crowd and he witnessed the execution of the Sahabi al-Jaleel, who was caught. They were in a small group of an expedition. They were sent out by Rasulullah SAW for a certain specific errand and task. A mission, they were captured, some of them were able to flee. Sayyidina Khubayb radiallahu anhu was captured, and then a public execution took place. In that public execution, all of the people of Makkah Mukarramah, the mushrikeen, children, elders, youngsters, all were called out to come and witness what will be the outcome of a person who chooses Islam. As a result of witnessing this action, every now and then Sayyidina Sa'id used to get fits. Thinking of that incident later on in life after he became Sahabi, and how that could perhaps be against him in the court of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. On this occasion, they asked the Sahabi, Khubayb radiallahu anhu, that would you desire that we ransom you and we replace you with Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in your place and we send you back home and let you go free. He said, Wallahi, Wallahi, ma uhibbu an akuna aminan wadi'an fi ahli wa waladi wa Muhammadun sallallahu alayhi wa sallam yukhazu bi shawkah. He says, By Allah, I do not desire that I am safe, I am free, I am comfortable with my family and my children in my home. And the Prophet of Allah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is being pricked with one thorn. Abu Sufyan and the people of Makkah, when they heard this, became mad. And they started shouting, kill him, kill him. They could not imagine and understand somebody who is ready to give up his life for another person. To this extent, We have seen loyalties. His key has seen loyalties. His key has seen support. Those support are ulterior, are given by ulterior motives. Either because there is a financial gain behind it, their families will be taken care of for the remaining of their days, or their past dodgy lives will be wiped clean for them, the records will be wiped clean for them, or because they will secure some kind of positions, or because they are afraid of the leader. So loyalties were there. But this degree of loyalty history has never seen and will never see. When a Sahabi is prepared, بِأَبِي وَأَنْتَ وَأُمِّي يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ O Prophet of Allah, may my parents be sacrificed for you. Many Sahaba came, may my parents be sacrificed for you, Ya Rasulullah. Sayyidina Abu Talha radiallahu ta'ala anhu, the day of Uhud, the battle of Uhud, is known as the day of Talha. Why? Because on that time, on that occasion, when some Sahaba, when they were under attack by Khalid bin Walid radiallahu anhu temporarily, then they were in disarray and they started running all over the place looking for shelter and for security. At that time, Sayyidina Abu Talha radiallahu anhu came and he stood as a human shield. He stood as a human shield in front of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam. My life means nothing. My car means nothing. My home means nothing. My wife means nothing. My family means nothing. My children means nothing. I am nothing. The world is nothing. If Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa is being attacked. قُلْ إِن كَانَ آبَاؤُكُمْ وَأَبَنَاؤُكُمْ At this particular time, in this particular weeks, the Muslimin should be heightened. And this is the dictate of the Iman. If we don't have the change of condition of our Iman because of what is happening currently, then we have some soul searching to do. قُلْ إِن كَانَ آبَاؤُكُمْ وَأَبَنَاؤُكُمْ وَإِخْوَانُكُمْ وَأَزْوَاجُكُمْ وَعَشِيرَتُكُمْ وَأَمْوَالٌ اِخْتَرَفْتُمُوهَا وَتِجَارَةٌ تَخْشَوْنَ كَسَادَهَا وَمَسَاكِنُ تَرْضَوْنَهَا أَحَبَّ إِلَيْكُمْ مِنَ اللَّهِ فَقَطْ أَحَبَّ إِلَيْكُمْ مِنَ اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ وَجِهَادٍ فِي سَبِيلِهِ فَتَرَبَّصُوا حَتَّى يَأْتِيَ اللَّهُ بِأَمْرِهِ Say to them, say to the world, beware and be careful. Beware and be careful, O Ummah of Islam. Forget anyone else. If at any moment in time, yourselves, your parents, your children, your brothers, your clan and tribe, your homes and dwellings, your businesses and source of income, anything that is attached to your life is more beloved to you than Allah, and not only Allah, His Messenger as well. Then wait for the punishment of Allah to come, because the punishment of Allah is near. Then wait for the punishment of Allah to come, because the punishment of Allah is very close. That personality, that hasti, that individual, where the creations of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala stood at his defense. The creations of Allah stood at his defense. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, on one statement, Allah came to defend the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He called his people, he called his close family and his clan, and he gave them da'wah of Islam. What did Abu Lahab say to him? Tabban laka sa'ir al-yawm. May destruction be to you. You brought us here for this frivolous and unimportant matter. And Allah Ta'ala revealed, Tabbat yada Abi Lahab wa tab. No matter he is the blood of Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, no matter he is from Banu Hashim, no matter he is the uncle, biological uncle, regardless of your status, regardless of who you are, you come across with respect and honor and reverence to the Messenger Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. لو كان موسى حيا لما وسعه إلا اتباعي Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said to Umar and Sahaba, when Umar radiallahu anhu went and he used to sometimes frequent the gatherings of the Yahud and he used to compare out of curiosity and with the desire for learning, he used to marvel at the fact that the Torah and the Quran have a collaborative nature. And Rasulullah said, I am alive and you're still going there?
By Allah, if Musa is alive, it will not be permissible for him but to follow me. When Isa al-Salaam will come, he will come not as a Nabi with a new Sharia. He will come as an ummati of the Messenger Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. No Nabi that came before Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was informed of the Messenger Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and his virtues and the fada'il of being his ummah, except that every single one of them desired, Allah make me of the ummah of Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Each one of them. Don't mess with the Nabi of Allah. We will forgo and we will sacrifice our lives. Don't mess with the Nabi of Allah. Because this is not, it is not something that is sensationalized. It is the dictate of our iman. When Rabbul Alameen came to his defense, then it is binding and wajib upon us to come to his defense. Even the animals of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala came to the difa and came to the defense of the honor of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, by Allah, I remember till this day a stone, hajaran, a stone that used to make salam to me in Makkah before I became a Nabi. I remember till today the makan, I can take you to the place, he said, of the stone, the specific stone that used to make salam to me even before I became a Nabi. Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, when he used to walk, the trees used to bow in sujood to him. The trees used to bow in sujood to him. Inna kafaynaka al-mustanzi'in. We will defend you. We will take care of your honor, O Master Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Who is Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam? We have elevated his status. Allah says, my love between me and you is pending until you don't follow him. قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهَ فَاتَّبِعُونِي. Then Allah will love you. If you say you love Allah, Allah's love is pending until and unless you are following the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then only will the door be opened for Allah to love you. Until then, Allah does not love you. Until then, your claim is false. Until then, you are hypocritical. You are lying and saying something through your tongue. Your actions are saying something else. Allah has made His love between the servant and himself pending upon the love and the following and adherence to the command of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Inna kafaynaka al-mustahzi'in. Let them speak. Let them say, latublawunna fi amwalikum. Share the speak this as well. Latublawunna fi amwalikum wa anfusikum. You'll be tested. This is the dunya. Don't think that, mashallah, tabarakallah, everything is going to be fine. You will be tested in your lives and in your wealth. وَلَا تَسْمَعُنَّ لَمْ تَأْكِدْ emphasis. تَسْمَعُنَّ نُمْ تَأْكِدْ emphasis, number one. The shadda on it, number two. And the verb itself, number three. At least three forms of emphasis, Allah is saying, you will indeed, most certainly, definitely, hear أَذَنْ كَثِيرًا. Much abuse. From you. وَلَتَسْمَعُنَّ مِنَ الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْكِتَابَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ وَمِنَ الَّذِينَ أَشْرَكُوا. Those who are hiding, those who are not only hiding, but they are proclaiming shirk, polytheism, idol worship. You will most certainly hear it. The days and the years of diplomacy are gone, long gone, brothers and sisters. There's no diplomacy left. You're Muslim, you mean nothing. Your Prophet means nothing. Your hijab means nothing. Your Quran means nothing. Now in this last two, three weeks, the Quran is being burnt every now and then in front of some of the masajid across the other parts of the world. Muslim blood means nothing. Recently, the files were leaked of the oppression of the Uyghur Muslims. Until this day, they were denying it. Your life means nothing. Your blood means nothing. Your Quran means nothing. Your Nabi means nothing. You mean nothing. Your Allah means nothing. لَتَسْمَعُنَّ And Allah has promised that this will happen. أَذَنْ كَثِيرًا Much and much abuse. And how Allah Ta'ala came to the defense of Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. إِنَّا كَفَيْنَاكَ الْمُسْتَهْزِئِينَ O Messenger of Allah, we will stand for you, don't worry. We will sort it out. Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he had a special maqad, a special throne, a special seat for Hassan ibn Thabit radiallahu anhu. Hassan ibn, activate your iman, brothers and sisters. Don't kill the Messenger Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam in your own homes. Don't kill his sunnah in your lives. Hassan ibn Thabit, he said, "Uhjuhum aw hajihim, and may Ruh al-Qudus be with you." He said, "Hassan, go and defend the honor of your Messenger Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam." Nafih, كان ينافح. He used to defend the honor of Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam through his poetry and his kalam and his words. And Allah's Nabi made dua for him. Allahumma ayyid Hassan. Allahumma, oh Allah, you help Hassan. Ya Allah, let his tongue flow with the praises of Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, your Nabi, just as he is defending the honor of your Nabi. So this ayah, I share with you, إِنَّا كَفَيْنَاكَ الْمُسْتَهْزِئِينَ Mufassirin write that it was revealed regarding five people, five of the detectors of Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Walid ibn Mughira, Asi ibn Nawail, Aswad ibn Abdul Muttalib, Aswad ibn Abdul Mughith, Harith ibn Qais. And Allah Ta'ala, look at how Allah Ta'ala defended Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Look at how Allah Ta'ala took care of him. So we say to these detractors, we can't stop you, go ahead. Do what you like. But let us remind you that whoever did this, they were met with a very, very evil hashar. They were met with a very evil outcome. So let me remind you, let us remind you that we might not have the power and the might to be able to front you. But we will hand you over to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who will deal with you as he dealt with the detractors of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So the Sayyidina Jibreel alayhi salam was sent specifically. He says, Ya Rasulullah, who is this man? He says, Walid, is he troubling you? Yes. He pointed to his legs and Allah will sort it out. He was walking, got pricked by an arrowhead. He didn't pay attention to it. That same thing became septic after a few days he died. Very long story short, Asi ibn Wail, that Sayyidina Jibreel came down. But he said, what do you think of this man? Is he a bad man, evil man? Is he troubling you? Yes. Asim pointed to him, to the feet of Asim. A few days later, again he was injured through a thorny plant, small things. His leg became like the size of a camel's neck. And then he died. So again we remind him, continue, please. And we want the world to see how Allah deals with people like you. Aswad ibn Abdul Muttalib. Then he said, Sayyidina Jibreel came. Asked him, what do you think of this man? He's a bad man. Sayyidina Jibreel pointed to his eyes. Allah will sort him out for you. A few days later, he became blind. And continuously began banging his head on a wall until he died. Aswad ibn Abdul Mughith came to him. Who's this man? He pointed to his stomach. He's an evil man. Jibreel pointed to his stomach. Yes, he's troubling the Messenger Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. A few days later, he died of stomach illness. Harith ibn Qais, these five people. Nabi Sayyidina Jibreel came, same question. Sayyidina Jibreel pointed to his head. And then his nose started to leak continuously, pus, until he died. Inna kafaynaka al-mustahzi'in. So go on, defame, blaspheme the Messenger Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. You will not be harming him. Because Allah says, وَرَفَعْنَا لَكَ ذِكْرَكَ Your adhan is incomplete except that you say, أَشْهَدُ أَنَّ مُحَمَّدَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ And Allah says, we elevated your status of messenger. Your iman is incomplete until you say, لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله. Your iman is incomplete until you don't say, أَشْهَدُ أَنَّ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ وَأَشْهَدُ أَنَّ مُحَمَّدًا عَبْدُهُ وَرَسُولُهُ Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, Nobody will come, no Yahudi, Nasrani, and previous Umam will come And they will fail to believe and accept me as the final messenger of Allah, except that the abode is the Jahannam. And the Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam says to us, O Ummah of Islam, La yu'minu ahadukum hatta akuna. None of you can reach the epitome and the completion of your iman until I do not become more beloved to you than your family, your children, your possession, and your own self. وَرَفَعْنَا لَكَ ذِكْرَكَ. We have elevated the status of Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. There's so much to be said, brothers. Don't be naive. Don't be foolish. Don't be quiet. Use the media that Allah has given you. Use the tools that Allah has given us. Make that noise. By Allah, if every organization does this, it's still not enough. What jawab will we have by Allah that when my Nabi's honor was being taken away, what did you do? When the stones and the animals came to his defense, what did you do? You sat quiet, you sat back, you continuously went to store our road and went shopping over there and allowing these people to boycott our Muslim businesses. You continuously supported their cases and you said nothing. Why? Because you want to maintain your passport or because you want to maintain some diplomatic ties. By Allah, let them cut you off from everything and Allah will suffice for you. Because for what reason we're doing it? Because of the Master Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And be sincere to that cause. وَإِن تَصْبِرُوا وَتَتَّقُوا. And Allah says to us, and if you are patient and you fear Allah, that's the important thing. Our Ummah of Islam, everybody is being patient. Everybody is being making sabr on the atrocities in Myanmar, the atrocities in Uyghur, the atrocities in Kashmir, now in India, and all over the dunya. The Islamophobia. The first part of the ayah we are doing, we're making sabr. But very few are making taqwa, yaakhi. Many few people are making taqwa. The first people to bash the sunnah of Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is we. The first people to kill him, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, are we. The first person to put the blade on the face and shave his sunnah is we. The first person to abuse his way of life is we. كُلُّ أُمَّةِ يَدْخُلُونَ الْجَنَّةَ إِلَّا مَنْ أَبَى قِيلَ وَمَنْ يَأْبَى يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. Every single one of my ummati will enter into Jannah, except the one who refuses. Who is that such a person, foolish man, to refuse the Nabi of Allah? Man ata'ani dakhala al-Jannah, man asani faqad aba. The one who obeys me and follows my path enters into paradise. The one who will disobey me, he has refused enter into Jannah. Come asr salah time and just check yourself whether you performed asr salah. Check yourself whether you did your fajr salah this morning. So we are the first. We should stand up for Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam in defa of these incidents. More importantly, we should stand up against our own self for killing his sunnah daily on a daily basis. May Allah give us guidance. I want to read to you some of the press releases. It's two of the press releases on international press release to give us, before mentioning that, the same people forget their legacy. They forget their history. In Harijan, issue date 27/07/1937. These are the words of Gandhi himself. You want to look at the success of a man? Look at his students. Look at his disciples. What does Gandhi say? He says he advises his congressmen as follows. I cannot present before you the examples of Sri Ram Chandra and Sri Ram Krishnan, as they are not personalities recognized in history. I cannot help but present to you the names of Abu Bakr and Umar. They were leaders of a vast empire and they lived a life of austerity. Who were they? The first students of the Messenger Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. So if you're saying bad about Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, then obviously you're saying bad of the Sahaba radiallahu anhu. And your own man is giving you advice to follow the Sahaba. So just quickly so that we have some context. The blasphemous statement spewed by senior representatives of the BJP are emblematic of state-sanctioned persecution of Muslims in particular. The rise in anti-Muslim sentiments, blatant hate speeches, communal tensions and mob violence in India, the direct outcome of the collusion between fanatical Hindu right-wing elements with the ruling BJP. The BJP suspended its national spokesperson, Nupura Sharma, from the party and its Delhi media head, Naveen Kumar Jindal, over the row over the derogatory remarks against Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Escalated internationally, the BJP has been accused by the opposition of pushing into India into a dark age of religious polarization, to subserve its parochial political agenda in the short term. The UAE, Saudi Arabia, and Iraq are respectively India's third, fourth, and fifth biggest trading partners. Their response together with other Muslim countries reflects the economical muscle displayed the role Muslim minority countries can play in stemming the looming genocide of Muslims in India. The expulsion of the two members from the BJP will not be enough to weed out Islamophobia in India. The defining credo of the BJP is in Butva, which thrives on anti-Muslim hate. We should be aware of the happenings around us. Bulldozing, what does it mean? Bulldozing houses, slapping sedition charges on history professors, university students, evicting hawkers, selling non-vegetarian food, creating controversies out of halal meat and salah venues, not to mention strange lower court receptions to this mosque is a temple petition. All of these institutional responses have been bolstering TV and Twitter right-wing loudmouths. Nivu Sharma and Naveen Jinnah's comments are products of this ecosystem. So just releasing a statement and saying that we denounce our association from these two individuals means nothing to us. The BJP's political ecosystem has to change if it wants to assuage tensions with the Muslim world. I want to read to you our fiancé statement as well, so that we know if we have not read it already. New Zealand Muslims categorically reject and condemn the recent remarks of the two senior spokespersons of the BJP-led government denigrating our beloved Prophet ﷺ. Such insensitive remarks have deeply hurt the sentiments of Muslims in New Zealand and across the world. The BJP-led government under Narendra Modi has once again raised the tension and sparked an outcry of Muslims living in India. Such deliberate acts by the BJP functionaries have occurred against the backdrop of increasing anti-Muslim activities in India, which surely has the tacit support of the ruling BJP government. The Modi-led government is silent against escalation of hatred and abuses of Islam and Muslims in India, particularly considering a series of decisions to ban headscarves in educational institutions in several Indian states, abrogation of Article 370 in the occupied Kashmir, and subsequent actions to change its demographics, lynching of Muslims by Hindutva elements, demolition of Muslim properties, and increased violence against Muslims. The Federation of Islamic Associations of New Zealand, FIANS, is saddened by such careless remarks and actions against Muslims and other minorities in India, and expresses its condemnation and denunciation of the derogatory statements made by the BJP functionaries. We note the perpetrators of the recent hateful comments against our beloved Prophet have been suspended by the ruling party. However, several BJP members who are involved in the hate and violence against Muslims are running free. We urge the Indian government to ensure minorities are protected and politics of hate is stopped in a country once considered to be a thriving pluralist society. Mr. Ibrahim Sheikh, President of FIANS, said, "We are deeply concerned that India, a country with the second largest Muslim population in the world and which claims itself to be the largest democracy, known for its diversity and coexistence, has deliberately allowed the Islamophobic discourse to reach dangerous levels. Once again, we implore the New Zealand government to use the diplomatic channels to strongly condemn India for its blatant violation of human rights of the Muslims in India. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant once again the honor and respect for the Master sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which Allah ta'ala himself has done. We cannot praise him enough, and whatever praise we do for him is never enough. Suffice to remind you that this on the absence of saying sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made curses for that person. Just on the absence of saying sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said ameen to the curse of Sayyidina Jibreel. So I implore you, brothers and sisters in Islam, the kuffar do not know our deen and our prophet. We know it better and we should show it to them by practicing upon the sunnah of the Master sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant izzah and honor back once again to the Ummah of Islam and to the Master sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Wa akhiru da'wana and alhamdulillah rabbil alamin.